Welcome to News Cafe, I'm Mitzi Borromeo. Tonight, we've got Asia's premier vocal harmony act, the most awarded recording vocal group in the Philippines, with 46 music industry awards received in the group's 29-year lifespan. Welcome to News Cafe, the CompanY!
Hello.
Hello, guys. So we have Annie Quintos, yes. Moy Ortiz, here. Sweet Plantado. Of course, we have Jay Marquez and Cecile Bautista. Thanks, guys, for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Finally! Yes, I've been wanting to have you all
I'm
here.
I'm a fan of the show, Mitzi.
And I'm a fan of the CompanY. Now let's start on how this group started. No, you all of mostly it was formed in Ateneo. No,
that's
Moy,
right.
Tell
Annie?
Us about.
Well, we back in yes, back last year.
back during the Japanese time.
Yes. Well, we were part of the Ateneo College Glee Club. Cecil, Moy, and myself. And after we had graduated, we still wanted to continue singing. Yeah. So although we did have jobs then, we'd meet every Friday and just rehearse and sing and just. For that void, there was a void that, we wanted to fill.
Withdrawal symptoms from choir singing.
All of you were in the choir. That's
right.
So after a few months had passed, parang wala, nothing was happening. We were just rehearsing. So we needed an audience. Hmm. And one of the members then owned...
Italian Village. That's like a restaurant.
Yes.
Italian restaurant.
And she said, "Oh, we can only pay you with pizza and pasta."
When you're a student, hey,
yes,
that's
my
not bad.
So we did. We did a Friday gig for about a month, and it was in that
one of those Fridays.
One of those Fridays.
Yeah.
Ryan Kayabiyab, who's a friend of the
of
friend,
the Glee Club, yeah,
yeah, said, "Why don't I? Can I use you for show?" He was musical director of, and this was for Celeste's.
At the Cultural Center of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. So that was in
85 pa lang yan, ha?
85 pa lang yan, ha? This is an hour show, so
we got the time. We'll walk through your memory lane.
So from there, one thing led to another. Our director there said, I'd like to use you guys as well. We were backup singers at that point.
That's right.
So, there's one Celeste Legazpi and 12 of us.
We were 12.
Imagine 12.
Yes. And so... one show led to another, and eventually, I think by the third year or fourth year, we said, let's try to have at least one number with
headliner, not just
as backup singers.
Not that there's anything wrong with that. I mean, we really love
nothing
doing that
wrong,
work.
But we also wanted to show
we
that
had other aspirations. So
So from there, I think it was in 1990 that we had our first recording.
It was 5 years to get our recording deal.
Yeah.
And from 12, you went to 6 to 5.
Yes.
Then there were 5.
And then
What happened? Why did that? I mean, of course, it grew over the years.
This really wasn't a... I mean, me personally, I have to fess up with them. Ever since as a child, I mean, I wanted to be a harmony singer. I knew that that was what I was going to do with my life. But for most of them, they didn't have any plans of getting into this in a professional way. It just happened that one referral led to another referral. So the people who left said, we didn't sign up for this. This was meant to be like a therapy club, and it's becoming professional. So people left, and they had other... life goals, so to speak.
Careers.
Life goals.
Yes.
So, but Annie and I are from that batch, from the 1985 batch, mm-hmm. and we're the old timers in the group, and these are the new.
Kuya and ate.
So, kuya and ate. So, yun.
In terms of the genre, it's hard to classify you, of course, the vocal. I mean, you guys touch on everything. How would you classify? Would anyone like to talk about what? Because you guys just really do all musical genres.
Well, I wasn't part of the group in 1985, but I do know that they were categorizing themselves as a jazz group. In fact, they were so snooty at that time that they would choose the hardest pieces imaginable, and they would perform intricate harmonies, so much so that some people really couldn't relate, and they had a hard time getting an audience.
They couldn't get a job.
There were instances where they performed to nearly tables and chairs lang talaga. Like you tell me.
And now sold out shows. Imagine once upon
God
a time.
Good.
So over the years, we've learned to reinvent ourselves and do more pop singing, as directed by our producers, so that we could be radio accessible. Because that's the way to go. So that people would. be familiar with our music, we had to be on radio and on TV. And if you were doing purely jazz, that's really not the way to go.
Now let's talk about your individual experiences, because all of you are really talented. You've come, as you said earlier, some of you are backup singers. Everybody, I think, was in a choir. Jay, yeah. Maybe you were also
yeah,
in a choir.
I was in a choir in high school in Lourdes, yeah. Mandaluyong.
Yeah.
And then in De La Salle, I also joined the De La Salle Chorale for a while. And then I got into musical theater.
You're with another band also, Q&A, before you
yes,
joined.
A Q&A.
You really did your research.
I have to do my research. It's scary. I'm with the company.
Yeah. Q&A and Noisy Neighbors, and I yes. was a voice talent for commercials as well.
Yes, you and Moy yeah. also, right? Yeah. You've done commercial jingles, commercial corporate jingles.
How you know, early on, like our mentor, aside from Ryan Kebya, there's this well-respected working musician called Babsi Molina. Hmm. She did backup for everyone for 4 decades. Early on, she told me, the more you have to offer in this industry, the more jobs you get. And that really stuck with me. So anything that's possible, I mean, right now we teach, Sweet and I teach at Mint College. Mm-hmm. But, you know, from arranging to producing albums and producing live concerts, what else do I do? Musical direction and all.
You compose, write a lot of songs.
Right? I write songs, yeah. So, yeah. I mean, the more skills you have, the more jobs you get. And just like any other industry.
Yes. Sweet, you're also...
The queen of reinvention. She does everything. You ask
choir,
her.
Though. I was in UP College of Music, and then my teacher was Ryan for music theory, and then he got me to teach in his... school, the Ryan Kayabyab mm-hmm. Music Studio.
I think we all did.
All of you, practically.
Yes.
No?
Yeah.
But when I was there, they weren't teaching. Ne. But yeah. I would see you, hi, the company.
As
yes,
I said,
hi,
we are the old timers.
Yes, yeah, and then I was still in school, but I was teaching the pop, the kids who want pop and musical theater. And then after that, see Mr. C again, Mr. Ryan Kayabyab. And let me join Tanghalan Pilipino CCP. Mm. So theater, yeah. My theater life began 1993. And then I joined trumpets 94.
Yeah.
And then 96 was Metro Pop. There I
yes, you won yes. the second prize. That was the I'm second prize for Shine.
Yes.
By Trina Bellamy, the Trina Metro
Pop. Research there.
The composer of Now That I Have You.
You all have similar music influences, no? I mean, you've
no,
also, do you
you'd
think?
Be surprised. No? You'd be surprised.
Yeah. Let's see. What were some of your favorites for you?
I'd always listen to The Carpenters, Barbra Streisand, and a lot of classical music.
Yeah.
But you were also, that's Sweet. Sweet is into musical theater.
Yes, and also Manhattan Transfer yes. because my parents Basha. Are musicians. So.
So it's in
so
the blood.
So old soul ako.
You forgot to tell Mitzi, you are also a film actress. Tell them.
She daming,
came, yeah, she had a debut film. Doobie Doobie Doo.
2 years ago. I was part of this movie musical, I Doobie Doobie
Doo. Yes, of course.
The Apple one, right? Tribute movie musical.
Ikaw, Jay.
I think the one thing we have in common is the Manhattan Transfer. I yes. remember watching a TV show, I think it was 1978, and I saw them in a kids show, maybe Electric Company. They guested and they sang Operator, and I got hooked into harmony singing since then. I got interested, I didn't do it, I got interested, but then because I started singing, my mom had to buy, and my dad, a karaoke machine, so I... So I started singing, and she made me go to Green Hills Music Studio for voice lessons and piano.
That's how
it started for me. And I, Manhattan Transfer.
Mm. Yeah. All of your music, Cecile.
Musical
also.
Influence, same. Manhattan Transfer, Barbra Streisand, The Carpenters, Sergio Mendez, yes, Diana Ross.
It's funny, her audience is going to say, they are mentioning all
they're dating
vintage.
Themselves.
But these vintage. Have been remade. What is interesting, all of these are classics, and they could, when you hear, in fact, when I heard it before, I didn't realize many of them, you know, some of the songs today are songs of before. So it's good. It's education through all through
and
music.
And you know what? A good song doesn't have an expiration date. Right. A good song is a good song in any decade.
That's right. Now, how do you choose the songs that you, because, you know, so you reinvent songs. How do you choose what you perform and the arrangements? Because all of you are also arrangers in your own right.
Yes.
Who takes charge, usually?
Well, that is my area of responsibility. Choosing the direction, musical direction, I'm basically, in terms of the direction, in terms of the music, and also artistic choices, where the group should go artistically, also image-wise, that would be me. So yeah. I think if, you know, recreating something is, we're not really interested in that. We're more interested in how can we make this beautiful song our own. Mm. You have to put your own stamp on the material.
And we have to take a quick break right now. When we return, we'll talk about the company's music through the years and their foray into television.
Ibig mo ay di totoo, di ko alam kung anong nangyari. Damdamin ko sa'yo'y hindi ko nasabi. Hanggang ang puso mo'y napagod sa paghihintay kahit agad. Saka ko lang naisip, hindi na kita. Saka ko lang
this is News Cafe, and we have the company lighting things up here. All right, guys, let's get into the music. Now, it's very difficult to do what you do because harmonizing is not easy, you know?
It's a different skill, you know? I mean, it's you have to get into a different space and different head. Harmony singing is really, different space. It's a different skill, so to speak. I mean, it just doesn't require you to carry a tune. Because
you need to find your place in a chord.
I'm going to ask you to sing one of my favorite songs. I remember I was in high school at the time, and I heard this song called Everlasting Love. And I thought, I know what everlasting love means. Of course I didn't. I knew it because of the song, but how could I know what everlasting
love
means?
Stop the bus. In 1990, you were in high school.
Somewhere there. Maybe I'm lying.
Amazing.
But I remember that song. I mean, that's a beautiful song. And that changed basically redefined the group, didn't it?
It did. That was the very first song that we... First pop song that we recorded on the first album.
Reluctantly, but...
Why reluctantly?
Because we weren't a jazz, remember?
Yes. Remember, we were musical snobs and... Actually, let's say it, musical bigots at that time. Ang feeling namin Atenista kami, we don't sing any old song there.
UP!
UP, Lasal.
It's good that we're the same. We're both from Lasal, right? Are we?
I'm not.
Yes, we are. Yeah.
She chose right. She went with the Jesuits.
We should not judge a person by their school. But anyway, so Everlasting Love propelled the group to a different
stage. It did. You wake up one morning and then we've been working. By the time we recorded Everlasting Love, 5 years had gone by.
Yeah.
And it was a difficult 5 years because we were just doing jazz and a cappella.
Hunger Games.
The Hunger Years.
Very, very current. And then you won the best record, best album for Yunna.
Won a lot. No? Best composition, best. Yeah. I mean, that's
best new group.
Best new group. Yeah. So it totally changed the course of our career.
So could we hear a little bit of that sample now?
Darling, did you know that something happened to us? Right before the future and right after the past, did you smile?
What a wonderful thing it
was. We found an everlasting love.
Oh, I love that song. Everybody falls in love. Doesn't matter. Another love song that comes out. No, it was. We're always on key. The company always on key. I saw this listed in one of the 10 top OPM love songs, romance songs. Now that I have you. Yes, it's come out. People, I think this is something people think of when they think of love. Tell us about that song.
Showers written by Trina Belamide, who's also Ateneista and also part of the Ateneo College Glee Club. I was able to travel with her in the 1989 European tour of the Glee Club, and that's how I got to know her. And then she graduated from college, and then she intended to go to advertising, and then I said, try songwriting, and then she gave us this song. Trina loves the Carpenters also, same as us.
But it started out as a jazzy.
Yeah, yeah.
Now that song, I have yeah.
evolved kind
it
of.
It did, you know. Evolved. And then she gave us the song. I said it lacks a little something, so she decided to write a bridge, and then things fell into place. We were looking for, after the success of Everlasting Love, we were looking for a nice love song that would also fit our group sound. So this came out in 92.
Yes.
So the second album, and you know how, you know, that phenomenon, sophomore jinx and sinasabi. So I was the monster of the group because I said, this is not going to happen to our group, the sophomore jinx. So we really made sure that the material for the second album was really good. And for that second album, we came up with two big hits, original hits, Now That I Have You and Muntik Na Kitang Minahal. So we were very blessed because that meant the success of the second album meant that the first album wasn't a fluke.
Yes.
After struggling for like 5 years, so it wasn't a fluke. So thank you, God.
Right, just you keep rising, it doesn't stop. In 2005, to celebrate your 20th anniversary, you did an anthology album.
That's
Is that right? The company, you. Yes. This was called
the...
Yes,
the
it was a double CD.
Yes.
Tell us, how did that come into... Why did you think of doing this? This is quite a big project.
20th anniversary?
Yeah.
It was a strange year for us. We were celebrating our 20th anniversary. We were going to have this big show at the CCP. But unfortunately, because of many circumstances, we were losing two members after the big CCP show. So we said, you know, we don't know if we are going to continue after 2005. So let's really commemorate it and celebrate the milestone, so to speak. So we decided to come up with a greatest hits compilation, but not just a compilation. It has radio interviews and it had our music videos. So it was sort of a mini CD box.
Yeah, it had a 44-page booklet.
Yeah, wow. Everything, because everything. I'm a rat pack. I keep everything.
Collector's item.
So, also. Yeah, so we worked on the booklet. I think up to this day, that anthology CD set is our best-selling CD so far.
Yeah, and this kind of propelled you towards your television career, because in 2006, you started working in television. So, of course, the Pinoy Dream Academy, you know, suddenly all these musical reality shows were coming out. And
it's a wonderful launching pad. You get known by the whole world because ngayon, where they produce those shows, but they have international TV. So you get known by the whole world. You get instant fame.
Social media.
Correct.
You're just really,
yeah.
You know,
so it's I mean, you know how tough it is. Tapos tayong mga Pinoy, we're so musical. Everyone sings very well. So it's a good launching pad, but it does not guarantee you a career with long legs. No.
Right.
But that's up to you. It's not up to the network to take care of that. So, but it is, to answer your question, yes, it is a valid and a wonderful way to get your name out there.
Yes, and it's wonderful that you also help people like this, because you launched an audio and video kit called The Company Presents Discovering the Singing Champion in You.
Yes.
So what were the key tips maybe,
I think
that
was also a first for the country.
It was the first.
I think it's a DVD instructional.
That's
correct.
What it is, yeah.
Correct.
You have basic vocal warm-up, workout exercises for the contemporary pop singer.
There are physical exercises also because when you perform, you use your entire body. So you have to, your entire body, you have to be in good condition. So exercise is really good and we do that.
Stretching.
Stretching.
Like stretching.
Regular stretch. Okay, so it's not just the vocalization.
Yeah.
Okay.
The whole thing, the whole nine yards. And
Well, basically, if you work with the when you work with the body, you just stretch the body, make sure that it's
relaxed
and ready to do anything to physicalize and to help you bring out the voice, no? Yeah. Bring out this, the good vocals, and then you work out the
you warm up the vocal instrument chords.
Okay. Yes, so. And you start with simple exercises just to slowly wake it up, and yeah. You know.
There are some funny ones too, like the trilling is funny,
yes.
Isn't it?
And the. And the dog pant, you have that. But that was really basically done as a warm-up. It's mm-hmm. not meant to replace a vocal lesson because yes. you do need in immediate feedback from the teacher. But we put that out as a warm-up for mm-hmm. for singers out there, yeah. professional and amateur singers.
And for those who are maybe in the provinces who may not
who
have
do
access.
Not have access yeah. to
no
school.
Proper teacher, mentors yes. or teachers, yes. Yes.
Although that's now, right. of course, they can easily go to YouTube and all of that. But we did it in a way where it's very, very accessible. The mode of speech mm-hmm. was Taglish, mostly Tagalog. Yeah. So it was... conceived and produced for a wider Filipino market, so to speak.
In that DVD, I remember, we really explained how to do it. So we wanted a DVD, a video, not just the audio.
Oh, yeah, so you can see.
Yeah,
it's visual.
Yeah, when right. you just listen, even in the 80s, I would see vocal warm-up tapes. It's dangerous lang if you don't know what's happening. Yeah. Because there's no explanation.
Physiologically yeah. speaking.
So in that video, we explain that this is what happens when you do it. Because our
it's
instrument
good.
Is inside, we can see
it's internal.
Yes, yes.
So there.
So it's good to be aware. You yes. have your body work.
It's still out, by the way. It's still out. Viva video. It's still out, and it. We're very happy. I mean, everywhere we go in the country, people say that we buy your DVDs and that DVD of that instructional. Does help.
Yeah. And with happy. That, two albums followed. You had the Christmas album and then Destination
yes.
Bossa.
Yes, no, yes, another that. Reinvention. I think that is also, aside from the anthology album, the Christmas album is also a bestseller. Thank you yeah. to the Philippine star music writer, Baby Hill, who keeps on endorsing it year yeah. after year. We're very proud of that.
It's
that
timeless.
That was her second Christmas album.
It's my first.
Her first. The first one was in 1993. But that was like a Christmas album of original songs.
Yeah.
This one, this the one you just mentioned in 2006, we did covers. Maybe we can sing a cut from that.
Okay, we'll take a quick break. When we return, we'll find out how the company have reinvented themselves through the years.
Tayo'y nagiliw, magsanang
You're watching News Cafe, and we're joined by the company. We have Sweet, Moy, Annie, Jay, and Cecile. All right, let's talk about some of the workshops you've done. You have also done summer vocal workshops. Who would like to discuss that? What happens in these vocal workshops?
Okay.
Take us through a sample workshop.
I started with trumpets in 1994. And then I joined company in 1999. I remember we were doing my first album with them, Recycle Deluxe 2, and our recordings are scheduled in the afternoon. So I took a morning class. I've been teaching adult classes, but that year I taught the children's class, and then we needed a teacher pa. So I asked Annie, can you teach children's class? So I got her to teach, and a few years later, I asked the whole group to do a pop class workshop. So trumpets, we try to offer different classes, different courses every year. Mm-hmm. So what year is that? When you first...
I think after Pinoy Dream Academy,
yeah,
so 2007.
After my mouth.
So they see Moy and Annie, they handle this pop.
Also, yes. Pop and class. The point is, it's not a song, pagalingan ng bosses. It's
proper training.
It's communication.
Ah,
it's telling the story right, what is the intent of the song, servicing the song. Pinoys are really good musically. So
that's right.
You don't have to teach them how to sing because they do know how to sing. The main point is how to communicate what the intent of the song is.
Well, it's wonderful to have all these opportunities because back in the day, people had to leave the country for opportunities like this, but you are bringing it to the country.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Actually, I remember saying that sayang, no, when if there were,
yeah, wala pang time, ganon, no?
Sana may ganon.
Oh. Right.
Now the kids, I mean, they all have these specialized courses na, and it's available here. So so it's a nice way also, Mitzi, at this point in our careers that you pass it on, you pay it forward.
Exactly,
to the
giving
next,
back.
You know, and instead na iswap ang mga skills mo,
tama.
You share it.
Right, especially like you're saying, the Filipinos are such musical people, so many talents.
Yeah.
So what do you think of the artists nowadays? I mean, of course, the style has evolved. Now we have all this technology. You've composed a lot of songs for some young artists.
Yes. I've produced and written songs for many, many Filipino.
Do you have any
artists.
Favorites? You're not allowed
but,
to say.
I do, but let's say the right thing here.
Yeah.
But there is no, how do you say this? There is no drought or how do it? Hindi nagkukulang sa talent. Dito. I mean,
sobra na talaga.
I mean, and in any, I mean, this is our 29th year, and we've been in the industry long enough to see, you know, the changing of the guards.
Yes.
But in every generation and in every reign of whoever the pop stars or the music stars of the generation are, you have brilliant people always. So it's not just, we don't want to be like, old farts, can I say that? And say not the kids these days, you know, they're no good because they are really exceptional.
Yeah.
You mean Sarah Geronimo can sing and dance. Between Escalante, we consider her the best singer in the land ever.
Yes.
So, you know, I mean, but having said that, each generation builds on what was done before. Like for our group, we have to give props to the new minstrels, ambivalent crowd, and all of these people who did good vocal work in the 70s and in the 80s too. So hopefully there will be, there are new vocal groups now, and a cappella is doing very well.
You've done some collaborations too. Like you also worked with Basil Valdez on his Christmas album.
Not the Christmas album.
Basil S. Valdez, I'm sorry. Basil S. Valdez album.
Yes,
is that it?
Yeah.
So how do you feel about these collaborations? Do you choose the artist? Of course, they choose you. But do you have a preference for the style? And
we're asked. we are asked, you know. Yeah, and
I think it's an honor and a privilege.
It's a bonus to be working with these people Basil. We've looked up to for so many years. Basil is the soundtrack of our high school.
Yes. I know. At 77, I mean, Basil was with Circus Band, of course, no? But when he exploded in 77 as a solo artist, I mean, everyone bought Basil. So it's really a thrill. The latest collaboration we did is a duet. We're part of the duets album of Pilita. He's the grand dame of OPM, no? And, you know, everyone was there. All the A-listers, they were there. Regine, Martin, Sharon. And they put us in the list. So we were really flattered. Here is a group, and they put us in the list. So it's so, really a privilege.
Recently, you performed in the Quezon City 75th anniversary, and quite the cast. How was that?
Very recently.
Yes,
it was a bit unnerving because, you know, like in most big productions, they have a teleprompter. So we had to learn the song just a couple of days before, even just
one day.
Just the day before. So we're being very honest here. We didn't memorize the lyrics at all. So we were relying on the teleprompter. And then when it came to our line, it stopped moving. For the life of me, I couldn't remember the first word.
And everyone was looking at us.
It happens to the experts.
Sweet remembered her line,
but she had no mic.
Solo ka na lang?
No, her mic wasn't on.
Patay ang mic. But moral of the lesson, memorize.
Tama.
Always. I felt so bad.
We all did kasi memorize. We had to learn a little harmony for that.
And it happens, it happens.
Well, it's life. I had to arrange. I spent like an hour and a half to arrange that. And then the prompter didn't move. So we just went like that.
So this is one of those... Sayaw-sayaw na lang, no?
Sayaw, no, it was just like a solemn...
It's a bayan ko and then mash up with Lupang Hinira.
Everyone was looking at us. It's your line.
You couldn't ham
it
up.
Just going,
so these are some of the things that happened. Any other stories like that? You know, some of the things that
happened. And it was after midnight. It happened after midnight. So we were just, okay.
Medyo tired.
What?
Well, our experiences with the Manhattan Transfer.
Yes, you worked with the Manhattan Transfer. How did that go?
More than once. Three times, you know?
Yeah, I think three times. Yeah. As in... they've become personal friends. They are musical heroes.
This is your cue to say that you're Facebook friends.
So friends na kayo. Yeah,
but they're very, 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 very accommodating and very friendly and very warm. These are like the icons of jazz, the titans of harmony. And here we are, this little group of ours, and then they how nice that they affirm you and give you validation for a hero. To do that to you, I mean, that's like unheard of. And it happened in our careers.
In fact, earlier this year, we were so touched and, humbled because Janice Siegel invited us. She asked for us
Manhattan
to be
Transfer.
Part of her solo show in
at Solaire.
Okay.
Excellent.
And we learned a song that she requested for us to sing with her.
Shaker Song.
So you performed with Basha, Kalapana.
I'm sure, my God.
We also met Richard Carpenter.
Yes.
Really? We sang for him.
What was that
like?
Wow.
Surreal. It's just like meeting the Manhattan Transfer.
Surreal.
Sure. And real.
No, she's Mitzi. She's not surreal.
I'm sure, and I know you're real. Well, that's amazing.
I mean,
you got to perform with these people you really looked up to. Yeah.
I mean, super nerd. I mean, with music, super, super nerd. I mean, I would make a vocal group in Bacolod and we would be in the costume of Manhattan Transfer. And cut to cut, 20 years after, you're talking to them. Yeah. They're nice to you. They're not condescending. Mm.
To this day, it's like a dream. Parang hindi nangyari.
And with, because before people, of course, there is always a need for marketing purpose. People need to label your categorize you.
Yes.
So we said, so what's your sound like? So we would always say, well, the hits sound like the Carpenters, but in the show it's like a mix of Carpenters and Manhattan Transfer. And it's unbelievable. Here we are in the Philippines in Manila and we get to meet Richard Carpenter and the Manhattan Transfer. So what are the chances of that your lives would intersect with the people that you really look up
to?
That
proof that when you really pursue your dream, you're good at what you do, you know.
In fact,
the planets align.
There's a little anecdote there. When we sang for Richard Carpenter, we sang this song that it was a special arrangement of his for Karen and
Baccarat, Hal David.
Yes, and it wasn't often that they performed that, and he was so surprised that we knew the arrangement.
So when we were singing, it was a private party. He didn't have a concert here. So when the song played, you could see his face go, "You're singing that?" But he was pleased with what we.
And I always like to tell the nowadays the generation, they know pentatonics now. Before pentatonics was there, the company was there even before pentatonics. They're great.
We do their arrangements. They are amazing. Even the Manhattan Transfer, they love pentatonics.
They're amazing. All right. Well, time again for another break. When we come back, we'll talk about the company's experiences working with other artists and their group's signature progressive cutting-edge styles and stage production.
Beginning today, I promise you, I give my to you. Beginning today, I promise to never part from you.
From now on, I will be right by your side, and I swear all the things I'll put aside.
Beginning today, there's no one else on my mind. Beginning today, there's nobody else right here inside my heart.
From now on, I will be right by your side, and I swear all the things I'll put aside.
This is News Cafe, and we are talking to the company. So you guys are known for your strong visual style, cutting edge, really excellent costumes. Who chooses? Who decides? Is there somebody that...
Our Optimus Prime mover.
Yes. So that's Moy. Okay.
In terms of imagery also, and aside from the music, because that's very important, especially now, more than ever. It was actually our former manager, Boya Bunda, who said that, you know, you got the music is respectable, he said. But I'm being facetious. But you shouldn't.
Spell facetious.
Never mind. I'm bad. There's no spell check in real life. But he said you shouldn't also neglect the visual aspect.
As an artist.
Of music. Yeah, yeah, right. So,
we had just returned from Japan.
Yeah, 1994.
In '94.
I love
that. That's
design.
Where our eyes dropped. Were
you
just
were inspired,
open,
huh? Yeah, because you gravitate towards Japanese and European.
Yes. Yeah. And unusual designs, really. Even on stage, the production design of the show. Because a lot of people are surprised when we do like a milestone concert. They would think that, you know, this is the company, they sing love songs, they just stand and be sweet and be all schmaltzy and all. But the show is very, very theatrical. It's very, very visual. And we like that. We gravitate towards also visual artists like, you know, Eurythmics or Bette Midler or Madonna. People who use not just the music, but the theatrical side of music
it's a sensual overload somehow.
That's right. And I think most music artists go that way.
Lady Gaga, Katy Perry.
It has to be visual. And it's also one way to reinterpret and to physicalize the music on stage. We work with a lot of a lot of Filipino designers also, both the established and up people who are coming up.
Established and?
And
not established.
And not established.
Well, you talked about earlier some of these difficult shows, you know, you're evolving with the shows. When you did your first big band show, that was the Let's Kick Some Brass.
Oh, that was fun. CCP Main Theater.
Yeah, how did you think that up? I mean, yeah, that was... That got two standing ovations.
Yes, thank excellent. You for mentioning that. That was, wait, let me retrieve, 2007, is that right?
Yeah. Yes, 2007. First in Davao, no? And then CCP.
Correct.
Yes.
And that was this is wonderful. We also got the imprimatur of Cultural Center of the Philippines. They co-produced it with us. And at that time, you know, hindi pa masyadong common ang big band, ang tugtugang big band. So we said, you know, it's not the most commercial concept, but we wanted to show that music with a lot of brasses can be commercial. So the act one was a lot of jazz and standards and even classical. Act two was really funky, dance music, R&B, and pop music. So that really went well. And Delicado, because that was the same night na Babyface was here.
Oh.
And then there were a lot of Filipino artists also who were holding their concerts that same night. So it was a tough sell, but napuno naman ng CCP. Oh. Thank God.
Then later on, another tribute. Such iconic performances and albums that you do. In 2008, you had Group Hug, your 18th album.
Oh, yes.
So that was a tribute to your iconic and legendary music groups.
Yeah, we worked. We had the privilege of working with Maestro Jared Salonga. And at the time, the orchestra was called Philharmonica.
Yes.
It was it's the first symphonic album, right?
Yeah. Of the CompanY. Yes.
It was, the sound was just really beautiful, heavenly. It's like heaven on earth.
An orchestra.
Wow. We pay tribute to groups.
Yeah.
Right?
That's why Group Hug.
Group Hug.
So Queen.
ABBA.
Can you believe we also did an electronic version of a song by Nirvana?
Galeng! Yeah, so
we did Beatles.
Beatles, of course, CompanY.
Yeah, well, we did. We did an original.
Oh, yeah, there's an original written by Moy.
So, it's so nice because basically, well, for the most part, Viva Records and Boss Vic Del Rosario gave us carte blanche, you know, to do, artistically and musically, to go where we wanted to go, which is very, very rare in a music career, especially here in the Philippines. But he imagine when we asked for a live album, sabi niya, okay, live album. He said yes. And then we gave him a live album, which was the 2002 CCP concert. It was all a cappella and classical music. I mean, it is really not the most commercial concept. But he said yes to it. And malaking utang na loob namin kay Boss Vic for giving us a recording career that...
Well, you set quite a path for them, you know, they've trusted you with it.
I know, carte blanche, really. Yeah. Go where we had to go.
Yeah. Then later on, you had the Lighthearted album, album number 19, Lighthearted, followed by Lighthearted 2, ito naman acoustic.
Series, yeah. It was series. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so this was like, I mean, naturally, we wouldn't think of this way. Na. It's mostly sa amin, Mitzi, it's like backward posturing. We would get classic songs and reinvent them, but Boss Vic said, no, you know, try to do contemporary, forward thinking. Contemporary material at the time 2010.
Much so, like Glee.
It's like Glee. Galing, yeah, it was like Glee. But we made it simpler, the arrangement simpler, so that it's more accessible.
Yes.
So
it's
lighthearted.
And lighthearted.
And that is the name of your new album, which you're launching, Hearted OPM 2.
Yes. Lighthearted OPM 2. It is the fourth album in the album series, Lighthearted OPM. It drops on October 24th, and at the same time, on the same day, we are having an album launch concert at
which
the
is sold
Museum.
Out. Congratulations, sorry.
Thank you very much.
We'll see bits of that. Yeah. I love that you get a CD when you buy the ticket. 295 pesos for your ticket, and you get the CD.
And you get the CD, yes. So it's na actually ang mabait yung aming our audience. Our audience, I mean...
Actually, pag kuha nila ng CD, may tax yun. No?
Joke! Additional bayad pala.
But what happened to our group is really an anomaly, if you can say that. I mean, it's a vocal group. It's usually...
A wonderful anomaly.
Usually, nasa fringe lang tayo. But the fact that we have this career, that it's still here, and people still buy our albums, and we come to our shows... it's not irony, but the blessing is not lost on us. We really have to acknowledge that this is really quite an exception. Everyone says past 30, you're done, you know. But
this
you know,
is the company. When you reinvent yourselves, you keep yourselves relevant. Let's look at the song you just released, May I Have This Dance. I mean, I just learned it's a song from 1979 by Vic Soto.
That's yes. right. And back then he was called Marvix Soto.
So why did you pick this song? What made
it
you
It was a suggestion by one of our good friends in the industry, Sylvia Makaraeg. She's a backup singer also, a partner of the person who, Babsi Molina, I mentioned earlier. And she said, you know, there's this song because everyone does VST and Company songs. You know, these are dance, OPM dance classics. But yung VST po, I think the Soto brothers were also involved in the writing and production of those iconic albums. And Vic Soto, or Marvix Soto, became like the Andy Gibb of the Soto brothers. He released a solo album of dance, OPM dance tunes, and that wasn't as big as Isasayaw, Awitin Mo at Isasayaw Ko. But it was a pretty and good song, and Aviva said, you know what? Do this, but do it in the style of mala pentatonics. So
yes.
It makes it more contemporary.
And in your video, so much fun. You guys, I love the style, the hairdo, so much fun. And you have Mike Salomon on this, no? Yes.
That's right.
I remember seeing him recently in Rock of Ages. Galing niya.
Oh my gosh.
Galing niya talaga.
He was the musical director of Rock of Ages.
Yes.
And
so here he does a lot of the beatboxing. Yes.
Correct. And I think this week he is in Taiwan doing King Lear.
Wow.
He's amazing. He is a genius, Mike
Salomon. He was my student in trumpets.
Wow.
That's right. That's right.
He was a teenager.
And we also
you trained him well.
Yes, yes.
He
yes.
was good.
Yeah. And dami yung estudiantes, Christian.
Christian Karil.
Karil. Uh-oh. So all. So.
So you guys have done so much. Some dream songs, dream projects you're thinking of.
Oh, to work again with Lea Salonga, to work again with Ryan Keabiab. To work again with the Manhattan Transfer. That would blow our minds. I mean,
And to guest again here.
Oh, well, that's not a dream. Please, you can be here every week.
Oh, you're sweet. But seriously, next year is our 30th anniversary. May we knock on your door?
Please. Always fun to have you here.
Please,
this holiday season, I mean, music really just, you know, it's a universal language. So wonderful to have you here. Thank you for sharing your wonderful selves with us.
I meant it, no bull. We are fans of your show and this station. You're doing great work. So thank you for having us, and we're grateful. Thank you, Mitzi.
Thank you, and we are fans of you. Thank you again to the company, Sweet, Moy, Cecil, Jay, and Annie of the company here tonight. And that's News Cafe for all of you tonight. See you next Thursday. I'm Mitzi Borromeo. Thanks for watching. Have a good evening. Hanggang umaga, ay marlang na kumakasin.